Hello, welcome pen friends. My name is Chris and I'm back with another ink profile. This is the number 6 ink in the Viewer's Choice series. So today we're doing Colorverse Supernatural. It's a really bright green and I think you're going to enjoy it. We're on the home stretch here, just these three left. So let's dive right in to the bath test with it so we can, as we're doing this, we'll find out what happens to it. And then I'll give the report from the last ink. The last ink we did was Robert Oster Soda Pop Blue, and that did behave very typically. Whoops, I guess I had written that upside down because I do see the little square and triangle and circle. You may not be able to see it. You can just barely read what was there, but it's so faint, I would just, call this a very typical fountain pen ink. That we wouldn't want to do our envelopes with unless we used a wax or tape or something. So there's that. So it looks like we're going to have another one about the same, but let's push that aside for now. We'll get into the Rhodia Gold book. That's my ink journal. So, oops, I just dropped a, that's really important too. That's one of our samples. Went flying onto the floor. Okay. Gee whiz. Here we are. So this is number 6 and we're filling it right in. We've just got two more after today. Let's flip right over and see where it is. Okay. This ink is something else. It's really bright and it really did a lot on Tomoe River paper as far as shading too. I found that it was available at Goulet Pens for $2 for a 2 mil sample. $36 for the 65 mil bottle and the 15. And let me just show you that in case you haven't seen what they are like. I got the Gravity Wave. That's the only one I've gotten in this in the Colorverse inks. And they give you the 65 mil bottle. Let's see. They give you this one and they give you the little baby one with 15 mil. So it is nice. It's very nice. Lots of ink. It's pricey, but you get a lot of ink, so it's pretty nice. And these are made in Korea. So this was in the broad nib in the Serendipity pen, and then I switched over to the medium nib in the Genhao X750. I liked it in both, and there were no dryness or flow issues whatsoever. And it just seems just right. You know, it didn't seem like it was dripping from the pen, but it wasn't... to me, it wasn't dry either, so. And when I started, I said, I'm not sure about this one. I may like it better for art than writing. But that turned around on me as I went through the whole process. And it isn't my favorite, like, color, because when we get into them, I'll show you a little bit brighter, even, as to my liking. But this ended up looking so nice in the writing. Let's just get right into the other notebooks, and you can see for yourself. Here's the Cafe Note by Nanami Paper Company with Tomoe River paper and a, let's see what it is, a 7 millimeter rule. And on this side, it's with the broad nib and the Serendipity. And on this side, it's in the medium nib with the Genhao X750. And I really, this was where I started to realize, okay, I like this. It has shading, maybe not totally dramatic, but there's a lot of shading in my view. And it looked really nice. So I could see myself writing letters in the spring with this a color like this. I like it. Not maybe not enough to buy it because I could go a long ways on samples that I have of this color family. And since purple and blue and, you know, the burgundies kind of grab my attention, this would be down on my list. But still, it's beautiful. And if you like that kind of, not quite so dark, but not definitely not muted, it's nice and bright. So things are going really super well for both of us, both my husband and I in our health quest, so that's good. It's always nice to go into the holidays in a good, strong position for that. This is the little book, Nemesine book, that came in an ink flight, and I like how it looks on here. I really do, because I see through the camera what you're seeing, and it looks very accurate, and I'm not sure what that's all about, whether it's the slightly cream ivory paper, or that could be it, but odd. Anyway, I'm continuing with the Boho Berry Challenge. So I write a little bit about each of their prompts. This was the time well spent, and of course, I feel like all of my time at my pen desk, my art and pen table is just my favorite time. I love doing this stuff. So this was with the Moon Man Mini Glass Nib Pen, which I've got up here. This has turned into a lot of fun for me using this pen. So, and I did a separate review on it that you can see. Oh, that's what my problem is. I wondered, I got a little bit of red ink on my fingers this morning, and I couldn't, so it's a cap issue. I need to clean out my cap. I must have stuck that on there at one time before I cleaned the glass nib. That would be, you know, something we'd do because we're used to just recapping a pen. But you want to always swirl that around in the water. So this was a really nice showing of how this ink goes from pretty dark green down to a bright lime green. I mean, it's got a lot of variation, and it's quite nice. So let's look on each individual. We'll do this quickly, if we can. On the paper samples, Chamoy River 52 gram. We get to see what that looks like there. And I like it. Certainly there's no issue with it showing up. It's bright enough and it's very nice. So and then here on Loistrum.grid, just about everything looks good on this. The only thing I ever run into is occasionally I run into bleed through issues with this paper, but this is pretty good. It definitely didn't bleed through with that one or any of these recent inks, so that's good. And then on Rhodia.grid 80 gram paper. Let me get it up there so you can see it. I started to copy Robert Oster. Seems lately I've gotten really mixed up too on inks. In my video yesterday, I mixed up it was actually a Three Oysters ink, and I tried to call it a Robert Oster ink. I think I did, which is just ridiculous. But anyway, here it is, and I see quite a bit of shading. It is a lighter ink to provide shading, but it does have it, and I thought that was really nice. So there's that one. And then we move over to Claire Fontaine, 90 gram French ruled, which is another monkey see monkey do, but we get to see the ink real nice. It shaded even more on the Claire Fontaine. I'm not sure why, but it did. It's a little bit heavier of a paper, maybe just a tad teeny bit more resistant. So it lays up there and then dries. So there's that one. And then the last one is my, I'm still using this notebook every day, the Office Depot College Ruled notebook. Kind of an economy notebook, but it's a nice one. And let's check for bleed through, because we have that sometimes. Nope, no bleed through with the broad nib even. And it tends to sort of make the color pop because it's just a little bit more absorbent. So it, well, quite a bit more absorbent than Claire Fontaine, but so you end up retaining more of the ink on the, it just gets into the paper. Not sure the words on that. Okay, we've got a fresh panel. I did a panel this morning because I noticed that the other green panels just weren't cutting it. So I get a fresh one. And that looks like definitely a typical fountain pen ink. Disappearing. Okay, here's our panel for today, which I'm kind of excited about. We got some doozies on here. Okay, here we are with our today's color, Colorverse Supernatural. And it really did compare quite well to Robert Oster Green Lime. Another nice bright green with a lot of shading too. And then we have the even brighter as far as intensity, you know, Caran d'Ache delicate green. That's quite a green too, but I haven't seen this as in a nib as much as the others. So, and then here is another one that compares, Noodler's Gruene Cactus Eel, which I had a tiny little sample of from a pen friend. I think it's because I used part of it, not that they sent me a tiny sample, but I used quite a bit of that, and I like it. And here's an unusual one, Noodler's Dragon Catfish Green. It almost looks like highlighter green. And it's pretty stable. It smeared a little. Not much, but it's quite water resistant. And then there's the Three Oysters Jade that I was trying to call Robert Oster ink yesterday. I don't know why I was doing that. And on our final ink for this ink profile series will be KWZ Green number 5 down here on the left-hand corner. And that's not why I put it on this panel either, really, because I think it showed up on another one even better. But I didn't have very many. You know, as I was trying to fill in, I had to choose some more to fill this one up. And this is one that I put on. And Lamy Green, which is being distorted by the light a little bit. I don't know why that is. Huh. And Robert Oster Opal Green. That may be why I confused these two yesterday when I was showing you the little jade artwork. It just wanted to come out as Robert Oster. But this was really fun. And I can see that there's quite a few to choose from. And, you know, Colorverse is right in there. But when you look at the price comparison, if you're going to buy a great big bottle of Noodler's Gruene Cactus Eel, and I don't know about the availability, so I shouldn't be speaking to that probably without checking into it. I'll check into it before I do the comments. But it would be like $12.50 or something versus $36. Then you're talking about, hey, you know, I might want to choose the Noodler's, you know. And the same thing with the Caran d'Ache. Those tend to be up there in price. And then you've got your middle of the line Robert Oster. You know, it's wonderful ink and at a great price too. So, okay, I think I'm just rambling. Let's look at the visual journal, which has taken a flight. Oh, it's behind the panel. Okay. Okay, so those of you who saw my video yesterday have already seen this in action when I was making these. You know, and it's interesting. Some of these I like a lot and some I don't. And I just, this seems like a mistake here. And yet it has a beauty and it shows us some of the chromatography. Very nice how it's yellow and lime green and dark green, and it has the edging. So we're getting what we need out of this. But as far as something to frame or put on a card, no, I don't like it so much. And I didn't end up liking any of these, really. But here they are. here's the other one that was, I don't know which was first. I can't remember. But this is one. And things were a little more defined at first. But after it dried, it changed. Which happens, you know. And then here's the other one, which I can actually see how I could improve that. So I actually had quite a few little ideas on that. And I'm planning a second video on doing Nick Stewart's process, because I'm going to check it out. I'm going to try it out on the next ink, which is leads to my next thing I was going to say. I'm going to try it out with Bunga Box Lamont in the same way I did. And hopefully I'll end up with a little short video for you on how this one came out. Because I think that there's interest, and I think that also every time I try to show something, I learn, especially after I'll realize, oh, you know, I wasn't actually following those instructions. I was doing some of this kind of thing before I started with the instructions. So I had built up these habits when I was doing this visual journal. You know, I did all kinds of, you know, just plopping the ink down. And I had all kinds of habits that were in place before I finally, I think it was Karen that pointed me in the right direction to finding how to actually do this. So I had a long streak of just, you know, playing around with it, and had built up some habits. Which I don't mean that we all have to do it the same. By no means do I mean that. But I like those little landscapes. So I'm looking forward to moving through this stage of just, you know, ink blobbing, which is pretty, you know, it's all very pretty, and into a little bit more, you know, where I'd have something I might be able to, you know, make a card out of or something, so that it's kind of neat. And, you know, we had some dramatic effects. It's not like there weren't, you know, fun there. I like that. But now, I will close because I'm rambling again. And I'll be back with Bunga Box Lamont, which is such a favorite that I burned through two sample, generous samples that were sent by an awesome pen friend. And then I ended up buying a bottle. I just couldn't help myself because I love purple. And, you know, it's purple, but it's also, it's like a bright violet. It's just gorgeous. I mean, I might not even be calling it by its rightful color family, but it's all I know is it's very pretty, and I'm psyched about this this next one. So I will see you on the next video. Thank you for joining me, and bye for now.